Hey, what's going on, you guys? How's it going? How many years has it been since you've last seen me on here? Like 4, 5, 6, something like that. Yeah, what's going on, you guys? I'm in San Francisco right now, so I thought I would do a little day vlog. I have a day all to myself today because my mom, I'm on a family trip, by the way, down here. My mom is in Napa Valley doing some kind of wine thing, and my dad and brothers are on a day trip to Yosemite, which I did not have much interest in. Not like I'd go see Yosemite, but like it's a 6-hour bus ride there and a 6-hour bus ride back, so that's already 12 hours on the road right there. I love how it just went like two, like that's 12, but it's 12 hours on the road right there, and then like a bit of time in the park, so it's like a full-on day trip. And I didn't want to spend the whole day on the bus, so I figured I would just stay around in San Francisco and explore on my own. So I don't really know where I'm gonna go. I'm just gonna play it by ear today. I'm definitely gonna go, well, it's kind of a lie because I'm definitely gonna go down to where the sea lions are, down to Pier 39, I believe it's called, and go explore around there. First, I gotta get breakfast on my own. By the way, it's almost 1 o'clock and I'm going to get breakfast. I slept in. but yeah, I'm gonna go get some breakfast, go exploring around, probably climb up this tower they have called Coit Tower. And apart from that, I really don't know what else I'm gonna do. We'll see. I'm gonna explore around. But yeah, I just thought I would do a little vlog today since it's been so long since I've last seen you guys, since I've last talked to you guys, that I should probably just hop on here and, you know, film my day for you guys a little bit. And since I have no one else with me, I figured I would bring you guys with me. So first things first, I'm gonna go get some breakfast. I know exactly where I'm going. I'm going to this delicious crepe place that's around the corner from our hotel. It's called Honey Honey. We went there, I think, the first day we got here. We've been here about 5 days now, but this crepe place is so freaking good, guys. So I'm gonna go there and see if they have any room for me. And yeah, after that, we're gonna head down to the waterfront area to see the sea lions, and that's pretty much my update for you guys. So I should probably get out of this room so that room service can come in and clean it, because I can hear them outside and I'm like, I should probably get going. But anyways, yeah, let's get going. Okay, so I just popped back into the hotel quickly. I'm done breakfast. That was so good, by the way. Like, if you guys ever go to San Francisco, you have to go to that Honey Honey place. It's a creperie. It's so freaking good. Everything there is just delicious. I can't say enough good things about it. But yeah, I'm done, but I thought I'd pop into the hotel because I need to use the bathroom, but also because I randomly got the idea that I wanted to film a time capsule video. So I'm just setting up for that. I got my tripod here. And for those of you that don't know what a time capsule is, a couple YouTubers have done them, but it's basically where you film a video talking about your current life situation, your goals, what you want. And you're basically filming it for yourself to react to in 5 years. It's typically 5 years. You can make it anytime you want, but I think 5 years is a pretty good threshold for a video like this. And y'all know I've talked to you in the fall about how lost I am in life. So I've wanted to film this for the longest time, so hopefully in 5 years my more put together self can react to this and just see how far I've come. So I've been wanting to do this for probably a year now. I've just never had the right time to do it, and I want to do it back home in my room in a familiar setting, but I'm not really gonna have much time to do that because my mom is getting surgery at the end of the month for her shoulder, so she's gonna be home pretty much 24/7, and it's always hard to get time anyways back at home just to myself to film videos and stuff. So and it's gonna be even tougher, like, again, with my mom around all the time. So I figured instead of this time to myself in San Francisco, we have a brightly lit room. This is a good opportunity to do it. So I've written down a few things I want to talk about in my video. And I'm just going to film this and hopefully everything comes out the way I want it to. And in 5 years time, I will react to it. So if you guys don't want to miss that video, then subscribe to my channel so you don't miss a video in 5 years from now. Yeah, I'm honestly a little nervous to film this. Like, I know for a fact that my 30-year-old self is going to be listening to that and reacting, and that's crazy to me. So let's get this over with. I probably shouldn't be doing a down angle, but I'm a weakling and my shoulder was tired, so I'm leaning against something right now. And that's the update. But anyways, after I'm done this, I'm gonna go down and take a cable car to Fisherman's Wharf, like I said, to go see the sea lions and stuff, which should be fun. So anyways, let's get this out of the way so we can get going on with our adventure. So yeah, talk to you in a bit. Gotta film this video. Bye. It's a little windy, but made it down to Fisherman's Wharf. I'll keep these on, it's too bright. But made it down to Fisherman's Wharf, it's gonna take some. gonna take some video on the cable car, but I was standing on it, there wasn't enough room to sit, and the yellow actually went to turn around because I wanted to get the next one so I could sit on it, but then the guy started yelling at me, he was like, there's room on here, stand on it! So I will say that the employees on the cable car are not, let's say the nicest people, but it's probably not a really good job, so I can't really blame them, but yeah, so I wasn't able to film any of the cable car, but I made it down here. I'm about to go into Musée Mécanique, which is a anti-coin-operated arcade, and I'll take some video for you guys, so let's go check it out. What my future career will be, and you guys know this is relevant to me, so let's find out. Okay. I'm gonna put my hand here. Ooh. It thinks I'm a lady. That's not accurate. Naughty Marietta do her stuff. Okay. Ooh, so scandalous. I'm gonna get demonetized. Oh wait, I was never monetized in the first place. Okay, I'm just over by the sea lions now. And what they don't tell you, they're cute and everything. What they don't tell you is how bad these things smell. They smell so bad. Lines are behind me, and what they don't tell you in all these videos of people taking videos of sea lions is how bad they smell. Guys, it's so bad. Like, just walking up the pier to see them, you can just get a whiff. It smells like algae and poop mixed together. So it's not really the best smell, but it's so much fun just standing there and watching them. Like, I stayed there for probably over half an hour just watching them. I'm gonna head back to the hotel because my mom is coming home now, and we have a dinner to get to. So yeah, I'll talk to you guys in a bit. Beautiful day today in San Francisco. So nice. Alrighty, so we're on a bike tour right now. And as you can tell, I'm obviously on the Golden Gate Bridge. It's a little noisy. Beautiful day today. San Francisco behind me. Alcatraz, somewhere around here. So, yeah, it's a pretty fun bike tour. Just waiting on Eric right now. He's up at the back of the bridge somewhere. But yeah, talk to you in a bit. I'm back home. excuse the last clip with the dirty airplane window. I had no control over that. I still wanted to get some cool like airplane shots, but my window was really dirty for some reason, so sorry about that. But I'm back home now, back in Canada, and it's really bittersweet, you guys. Like, I'm very happy to be home and back, getting back into my routine. I'm just in the gym parking lot right now, about to go in and work out, so I'm getting back into that routine. But I really freaking love California, guys. Like, I just feel so like, I feel weirdly at home there. Like, it's such a nice place. I love the weather. I love the people. I love the scenery. Like, it really does give Canada a run for its money. And I would so badly love to just move there, but I can't because I make it sound so bad. I was gonna say I'm stuck here, but it's kind of true. Like, I can't just move to the States because I'm Canadian. So one day, hopefully I can get a green card or some kind of work visa and move there. That's kind of the goal at some point. But for now, I'm stuck in Canada, which isn't so bad. But yeah, I'm back home. Funny story, actually, when I was at the airport, going through security, which, by the way, airport security is like my least favorite thing ever. I get so stressed out and anxious going through airport security because I'm always so scared that even though I'm completely innocent, like, I have nothing to worry about. Like, I'm always worried they're gonna find like some bottle of like hand sanitizer in my bag and like lead me into like some back room to like interrogate me about my involvement with terrorist organizations. Like, that's how much I stress out about airport security. I always worry that they're gonna like convict me of something on the spot, which I had like no control over.
like, so anxious in me, I know. But, anyways, I just went totally off track to what I was saying. When I was going through airport security, now it's, like, they've really beefed up security. Like, I remember when I used to be able to just go through the little, like, metal detector and I was good. No, now they have these, like, big cylindrical chambers where you have to, like, go inside and put your hands over your head and this thing, like, spins around you and gets, like, an x-ray of you. And to do that, like, you have to take your belt off. You have to take anything metallic off. So I was wearing a belt. So I put it off, I took it off and put it on the tray to go through airport security. But, like, my pants are really loose, you guys. Like, I just got a new pair of pants and I made sure to go one size above what I actually am. Because my struggle has been the past couple of pants I've bought at my current waist size. But, like, I think I've told you guys, like, I'm gaining weight. Like, I'm gaining lean muscle weight in the gym. And with that, my waist size does grow. So my past couple of pants I've had to, like, I've only been able to wear for, like, a month or two before they're too big for me. So, okay, maybe a little more than a month or two, maybe, like, 3 months. But still, like, the fact remains, like, they get too small for me too quickly. So instead of, like, spending, like, $100 on a pair of jeans I can only wear for a temporary amount of time, I figured this time I'd buy a pair of jeans that's a size above what I actually am so that I can wear them for longer. I'll grow into them and I'll be able to wear them for longer. The only problem with that is that they are a size above, so I need to wear a pretty tight belt for them to fit. So I had to take that belt off to go through airport security. So my pants were super loose. Like, I had to hold on to them to make sure they wouldn't fall down and I wouldn't moon everyone who's, like, going through security. But I had to go into this chamber and put my hands over my head. Like, I couldn't hold my pants up for that brief moment I was in there. And I was so scared that, like, my pants are just gonna go down while I'm in this machine getting, like, x-rayed or whatever they do. So I was so scared about that, but thankfully that did not happen. I went in and I just pulled them up as high as I could and just prayed that they would not fall down, and thankfully they did not. I didn't have any issues. Would have been kind of funny if they did fall down. That would have been a good story time for YouTube, but it did happen. So I went through, everything was good, and we're back home. So that's that. But anyways, I had an amazing trip. I don't know how much I vlogged. This might be a little mishmash, mishy-mashy, whatever the term is. Because I just pulled out my camera whenever I could. We were so busy every day. I pulled out the camera whenever I could. So I hope you guys enjoyed coming along my trip for whatever I filmed. I had an amazing time there. San Francisco is an amazing city, you guys. California is an awesome state. I can't wait to go back. And good news, you guys, about my channel. I'm starting to get, like, that creative bug again. Like, I'm kind of missing YouTube. And going back to California and experiencing that, like, kind of culture again, it's kind of motivating me to get just my butt back into the YouTube saddle to try and get to that point where I can have enough subscribers and enough, I guess, attention on YouTube that I can essentially get a visa and move there. Like, I'm really feeling motivated after going to California to really get back into this and give it my all and just keep trying for this YouTube dream that I got. So I'm really excited about that. The bad news is that my mom is getting shoulder surgery in a couple weeks, like at the end of this month, and she's gonna be at home the entire summer. So I've told you guys before, it's really tricky for me to film at the best of times because I live in a small house with, like, four other people. So filming, like, having free time to film is always kind of a luxury. But especially now with my mom, who's going to be around all the time, filming is going to be really, really, really tricky for me. So I don't know how much I'll be able to film this summer. But I am getting that creative bug again to get back into this and to get filming. So, I'll see. I'm going to see if I can find any time to film and try to get some videos. I have a couple of ideas in my head that I want to do. So we'll see if I can do those at some point. I think also I'm gonna do another update video because I have to change the update video on my channel because, like, my default video on my channel is still the 1,000 subscribers giveaway, which I've already done, and it's like 3 or 4 years old. So I'm gonna film a new one, and I think I'm gonna change my schedule from every Friday to just being whenever I want. I think that's gonna be a lot better for me instead of, like, forcing myself to stick to the schedule and put out, like, crappy subpar videos. I think it'd be better for me to just make it a whenever I want channel so I don't feel that stress and pressure to, like, get something out every single week. That way I can put more effort and time into videos that I actually care about. So anyways, I'm still thinking about it. I have a whole summer to think about it because, like I said, my mom's going to be around all the time and I won't be able to film. So I can at least, like, think about what direction to go with my channel. But yeah, I just wanted to let you guys know that, like, I'm getting, like, I'm wanting to get back into this again. Like, I'm coming back around wanting to do YouTube. So, yay, get ready for Mark's return at some point. But in the meantime, I hope you guys enjoyed this vlog. Please give this video a big thumbs up. Ooh, it's been a while since I've done this. I'm going to be a little rusty. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Leave a comment below letting me know if you guys have been to California. Did you enjoy California? Do you also want to move there like I do one day? do let me know. Be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel for, I guess, vlogs and videos whenever I decide to come back and return. Yeah, do subscribe. Hit that button down below. Also, be sure to follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat. All links for those will be down below and at the end of this video. But yeah, anyways, thank you guys for watching this video. I love you guys, and I'll see you whenever I come back on here. Bye!